Jox means is defying labels, so proving labels wrong, and that's what our motto is, and then our slogan is "Fuck labels, we defy ourselves." So it kind of relates to me and my friends growing up being athletes. Of course, we're from the inner city, so like they probably didn't expect much from us growing up, except for being athletes. But we all, me and all my friends, we made it to college either through sports or academic. I went to Whitman on athletic slash, I guess, academic scholarship. And one of my friends went to Wazoo and Eastern and a couple other schools. And I think what came with the brand is just saying that sports isn't the only thing that defies us. So I guess the bigger picture is just for the brand is where it connects to everyone, is just saying that don't let labels defy you, you defy yourself. And that's pretty much the meaning of the brand. So the purpose of Dumb Jox is just, so we're kids from the inner city, so it's just showing that you could be more than what people interpret you to be. It's just a lifestyle that we live. We believe that we can achieve anything, and that everything we do is based on our mindset. So no one could put us in a box, or and we just defy ourselves. So that's pretty much what Dumb Jox is, and what our purpose is, to show everyone that pretty much you defy yourself, and anywhere you want to go, it's up to you. Dumb Jox got started, it was my junior year in college, so I'd say that was 2012-2013, around like spring break. What kind of really made me get started, because we were contemplating the clothing line for a while, is I had got hurt that season for basketball. So of course I had a lot of downtime to do different things besides rehab. So that's when it officially got started. We hit up a printer because we had the design, a couple of designs ready already. Hit up the printer, got the shirts made, and then we advertised on like Facebook and Instagram, and then trying to see what like kind of feedback we would get. And so after that, we came out with a couple shirts and they sold, so we decided to just keep doing it. And after doing it for a while, everything was pretty much selling, so we thought it would be a good idea to maybe make it a business and take it a little more serious than just being selling t-shirts for fun, pretty much. Probably didn't become like a business until after I got out of college, because I was obviously busy with college, and there's a lot of trial and error in between that. So out of college, I started working with a couple of guys who print it, and start learning how to print myself, and pretty much trying to cut out the middleman to where I'm more into the business, and instead of just outsourcing everybody. So I'd say around 2015, 2016 is when it actually became a business for us. For my design process, it usually stems from my idea. And depending on what the idea is, I do a little research on like Google or Pinterest or whatever, and just to get ideas that how I'm gonna create that vision, pretty much. And then after that, then I start sketching different ideas, and once I sketch something or figure out how I'm gonna execute it, then I go to the computer and then I create that that vision, pretty much, and kind of make it a reality. Then after I make the design, then I'll make mock-ups or whatever, throw the design on shirts and mess with the colors and different things like that. And then also get feedback from like peers, like my friends, and probably family members or whatever. And then after that, it just goes into a folder, and we decide if we want to come out with it or not, or like combine other designs to go with it. And then after, if we decide to put it out, then we'll just print it on shirts, and then take pics, advertise it, and then see how it does.
What made me create that logo is just I believe that everything we do in life, or just to achieve certain goals, is all mindset. So I guess a couple of things when looking at the logo, the big eyes, is just paranoia. I guess being paranoid at trying to get to a certain goal, or like reaching success or whatever you want in life. And then the hat is just for, I guess, swag, whatever. Your identity, how you carry yourself. And then the saliva, it kind of reminded me of like a baby, like when they, they just slobber and stuff, but they can't control it. And not controlling it is just passion. So having passion for whatever you do. And it kind of just goes all together when trying to live life, pretty much.
Growing up, I wasn't really sure if I was gonna be an entrepreneur or not. I know, like, growing up, I wanted to be an architect or do something in art, but I didn't really think it was gonna be like something I like actually was gonna do. Like, going to college, like, I thought I was gonna be a business major, but things changed kind of like in college, because you're exploring, trying to do different things. And I just went with the stuff I liked. I was a art and sociology major, so I've always done art, so I kind of knew I could be an entrepreneur just based on like the artwork that I did. And my dad was an artist growing up too, so he's pretty much kind of like an entrepreneur in a sense. So I kind of followed him in a sense, trying to just make my own art. And because he did airbrush and tattoos, so that was his art. And then my art's through t-shirts and digital work. So after I saw myself make money doing it, then I realized that I could probably make something out of it and make it a business and be an entrepreneur. Biggest obstacle about being an entrepreneur is just probably self-discipline. You pretty much gotta stay on your grind. Some days you may not get work, some days you might get work. It's just trying to stay consistent, keeping to your values, trying to find a routine that works for you. Because with a regular job, you have to do certain things, but being an entrepreneur, you might slack, and then that's your livelihood. You might miss out on money or miss out on opportunity. So I think self-discipline is probably it's the hardest part about being an entrepreneur. I think the best thing about being an entrepreneur is having something that's yours and not really having the answer to somebody. I have a quote for my design business, and it's called Create Your Utopia. So I feel like everyone should have something that's theirs, whether it's a business or maybe you publish a book or do something. But I feel like with that quote, I feel like people should have something that's theirs. And also with my design company, with that quote, it's create your utopia, turn your visions to reality. And I guess what my job is to like turn your vision into reality and make something that's yours, pretty much. So I think the best thing about entrepreneur is just what I said before is having something that's yours, and it's rewarding once you're grinding for something that you want and create, I guess, achieving your goals pretty much. So I think that's the best thing about being an entrepreneur. So the thing I would probably tell myself when I was in college, before I graduated, was probably more self-knowledge, trying to teach yourself new skills and different things that your teachers won't teach you. I feel like your teachers do know a lot, but kind of finding things on your own. Like, I found a lot of stuff on my own after college with design and different things like that than what my teachers taught me. So seeking self-knowledge, I feel like, is a good thing to do while you're in college, because then you have two sides of the spectrum, pretty much. So.